spending more time thinking about this than I do about music, and that's my livelihood.
It's Celebrity MasterChef. All this week, 12 celebrities have been battling it out for a chance to become Celebrity MasterChef.
Matt, congratulations.
Well done. Sherry. Midge. Well done. Craig.
They've been whittled down to four exceptional cooks. Midgeur is the world-renowned musician.
Midgeur, I mean, the man's an absolute legend. What the whole world didn't realise is what a fantastic cook Midge is.
Sherry Hewson is the acting star of Coronation Street and Emmerdale.
Sherry, an actress, there's an experienced person, because she's a very, very good cook.
Craig Revel Horwood is the infamous Strictly Come Dancing judge and choreographer.
We do see a great cook in Craig, somebody who has amazing potential. He has great palate.
Matt James is the much-loved TV garden design expert.
His food is experimental, slightly left field, but everything he does is done very well.
All four believe they have the talent and the skill, but the competition is about to get tougher. First, they'll face the classic recipe test.
It's delicious. It's well seasoned. I just wish we had more dressing.
Then they have to wow the judges with their own three-course meal.
It's a beautifully blended chocolate dessert, and I want to snog it.
At the end of today, only two will become semi-finalists. The other two will be going home.
Quarter-final day.
At the end of it, we will lose one of you. Off you go.
Following identical instructions, they have just 30 minutes to create a classic Caesar salad recipe. Caesar salad is made with gem lettuce, croutons, and Parmesan cheese. The skill is in perfecting the dressing, made from anchovies, garlic, and raw egg yolk. The celebrities also have the option of adding bacon and chicken to their salad. Their skills are being judged by the experts. Greg Wallace.
Classic recipe test. All four of our celebrities, they're all on the same playing field.
And John Turode.
I don't want to see soggy, undry lettuce. I don't want greasy food. I want lovely, clean, crisp flavours.
At the end of this test, one of the celebrities will be sent home and not go through to today's second challenge. Craig is a natural cook with a flamboyant streak that makes him prone to add one ingredient too many.
Beautifully cooked soft meat, all right, but garlic coming in between the cherry, unusual.
It doesn't need, you know, all the component parts are in there.
I'm a risk taker, and yeah, I tried something, you know, that didn't work last time, but this time I'm still not playing safe. This has become for me now a personal challenge.
What do you think is the most difficult part of the salad for you, Craig?
This bit.
The dressing?
Yeah, the dressing, because dressing makes the salad.
You're here because we reckon you are a very, very well flavouring cook. Is that for you what food's all about big flavours, do you think?
Food is absolutely only about flavours.
It is a competition, Craig. You're here to win it. Can you win it?
Yes. I think if I put my mind to it, I can win it.
Garden expert Matt is the least experienced, but he's intrigued the judges with his experimental cooking.
Everything tells me to dislike sticky fruit and fish, and it scares me that I like it.
My biggest weakness, without a doubt, is the kind of basic stuff. It's supposed to be a classic recipe that we should all be able to cook. The more I think about it, the more I think, oh dear.
Are you able to just envisage a simple, delicious salad?
Yes, I think so. I'm not putting any chicken in whatsoever. I've got the bacon because bacon and fish, generally speaking, tend to go together quite well.
You're acutely aware we're going to lose one of you after.
Yeah, and that will be gutting.
You've had 15 minutes, you're halfway.
So far, Midge has shown great technical skill with his impressive Asian dishes.
Sukiyaki, all the flavours are in there, and all you want to do right now is go back and have another couple of mouthfuls. It's great.
That is gorgeous flavour. That's pretty dreamy stuff.
I am passionate about it. I am driven about it. It's my other love in life, music and food. It's the best two things you can have.
Midge, quietly, confidently, doing stuff here?
Not really. I've never cooked this. I've never made a Caesar salad before.
Do you, you know what the Caesar dressing should taste like, though?
I'd like to think so. Yeah, creamy, it's mayonnaise-y. It's a salad.
You've still got a smile on your face, but it is a competition, Midge.
Yeah.
How are you feeling about the competition?
I want to do the best I can possibly do. And unfortunately, if that means, you know, beating some of these guys, that's what has to be done.
10 minutes left!
Despite some scruffy presentation, Corrie actress Sherry has delivered some perfectly cooked dishes.
That is absolutely perfect. I'm really, really happy with that. The tuna is just cooked perfectly. That is it.
I think I need to stay on a steady course of cooking good food with the right combinations so that they can see that maybe I've come on from when I started, which was a mess.
Why do you think that we've set this recipe, Sherry?
Because it's classic and because it's simple. I guess that's what you're looking for, that clean taste and sharp taste of every single flavour.
Are you confident? Will you beat these lads?
I'll give them a damn good run for their money.
5 minutes left. That's it! Finished!
We'll start with you, Sherry.
Oh.
Because you're nearest.
Yes, all right.
My major problem right now is that we've got bits of burnt garlic in it.
Ah.
And that burnt garlic, it's going to be really bitter. The main problem is that you put hot chicken in there and the hot chicken's starting to cook that lettuce.
I quite like your dressing. I think it's just a little bit scruffy.
Yes, a bit mad. I know how it feels. I would like to go on in the competition. I am still passionate, and I would really like to stay to prove that I can do more than I've done already.
I've got to go straight to this yolk, because there is no avoiding it. It's shining on the top of your salad like a beacon. I think it was a dangerous thing to do.
Yeah, exactly. I like it. If you break it and mix it through, it's actually very, very nice.
I agree with you over the egg yolk. Sticky, lovely. Lovely, lovely texture.
The lettuce is crispy, the croutons are crispy and soggy in the centre. It is very, very strong, and I don't mind the bacon with us at all.
I put a raw egg yolk on my Caesar salad. I thought, well, you know, why not? that could have actually put me out, I think, you know, but in fact, I think it might be an element that keeps me in.
Well, Midge, it's a far neater salad than the other two. That's got a definite taste of salty parmesan. You definitely pick up the anchovy in there as well, a hint of garlic. It's a good sauce.
It's delicious. It's well seasoned. The balance is great between the anchovies and the parmesan. There's not too much lemon juice in there, it's not too acidic. I think it's great, great tasting, I just wish we had more dressing.
I got lovely comments about the salad, which is amazing, because I don't like anchovies, so I wasn't tasting it. I tasted the sauce at the side just to make sure it was seasoned properly.
I so want to love it. I can't, because there's no dressing. It is a bacon, cheese, bread salad.
I like everything as it is in bite-sized chunks. I think that is great. Crunchy crouton, nicely done. Salad's got crunch. Nice parmesan saltiness. Everything but the anchovy dressing.
Matt, do you think this is good enough to get you through?
I hope so, but I don't honestly think so. I think not having enough dressing will definitely let me down, because
It's a Caesar salad, which is renowned for its dressing. And let's be honest, it doesn't have many other ingredients, really.
We have to sit on the couch, John and I, and unfortunately, really unfortunately, lose one of you.
Give us a chance, let's have a chat, and we'll have to make that dreadful decision. Thank you.
Oh dear.
There was only one decent dressing, and that was Midge's. So, in my mind, Midge secures his place, and the other three are fighting tooth and nail to stay in the competition.
The problem, of course, with Midge was he just didn't have enough of that dressing, but it was definitely the best dressing.
It was quite a minor mistake, I think, overall. I think had I coated the whole salad and it tasted dreadful, then I'd be really, really, really worried.
Let's talk about Craig. Craig is just true to form. He still doesn't know when to leave alone. There was too much salt in there in the end, but the egg was a brave thing to do.
It did have lots of flavour and it was almost there, and it was probably better than both Sherry's and Matt's.
You do try and make things differently and try and, you know, experiment and be bold and be brave, and that's what I do.
For my mind right now, I think it's a fight between Sherry and Matt.
It does look like Sherry may have dropped hers from 6 feet away, but it tasted of something.
I knew it was a bit messy, which they've said to me before. I thought the anchovy sauce wasn't too bad, but it could have been better.
Sherry's Caesar salad tasted like a Caesar salad. Matt's tasted like lettuce, bacon and cheese.
I right now actually want to defend Matt, because everything he does do is precise, is well flavoured, and even without very much dressing, that salad had some flavour.
I thought I did pretty well up till then. I was quite neat and I was quite tidy. I'm gutted because I'm frustrated that I didn't, you know, just didn't put some enough damn stuff on.
John, he's got 50% of your salad missing.
Three of you are cooking, and one of you's going to get up in a minute and leave us.
We made our decision, though.
Sherry, you're leaving us, I'm sorry.
Okay. Thank you. Bye. Bye-bye. It's sad because you actually want to go on because you've got so excited and you just want to prove it to everybody at home and everything. So I am gutted, but I've enjoyed this so much that I will go on and probably cook more. Have a little patience.
Well done, guys. You're still here. You got a chance to cook the wonderful dishes you've been practicing.
Now, you have got to cook extremely well, because we are still going to lose one more of you.
Cook like angels and you will be going through to that final.